memories are, yeah, seeing day trippers come and unloaded by coaches. And it was rather a hubbub of Birnbeck Road. Everybody seemed to be enjoying themselves, laughter and talking.
On June 5th, 1867, Birnbeck Pier was officially open. A bank holiday was declared, bands marched, people cheered, and little did they know, the citizens of Weston-super-Mare had stumbled upon a treasure for the town that would last for well over 100 years.
I remember in the early 50s, going with my mother and father and my brother onto the pier to play slot machines and buy candy floss and all the things you'd expect at the seaside. It was always crowded with people, children with rock and candy floss, and people putting pennies in their machines on machines that were on the pier. And it was just a lovely, lovely place to go to.
But in 1994, it was closed to the public for good. After struggling with costs and being severely damaged from horrendous weather conditions, a long-lived era came to an end.
Being a police officer in 1965, that was my first station, was at WESTON. And part of the job of the police patrolling the seafront at WESTON came to the Grand Pier, checked the Grand Pier, and then we would move on to Birnbeck Pier. The method of communications would have been by beach telephone. There was no radios other than using a telephone box. So if there was a problem, then we would dial 999 from the Coast Guard, say, from near Birnbeck Pier was a telephone box.
Growing up, WESTON is somewhere that I went frequently, usually with my grandma. And school holidays, my grandma would say, "Where do you want to go today?" And it was always like the same set of choices. So being from Bristol, living in Bristol, my gran would say, "Shall we go to the pictures? Shall we go up to the museum? Or shall we go to Weston?" And if the weather was nice, particularly in the summer holidays at school, we would go to Weston. So it was probably my gran, or I was probably with my gran the first time I saw Birnbeck.
I vaguely remember it was used for the steam paddle steamers that used to come into the pier. I believe it was Campbell's boats come in there, and this would take day trippers across the Severn to Barry Island and bring them back mostly the same day. They would go out in the mornings or afternoons and come back evenings, late evenings. It's a great thing. Oh, 11 o'clock, 11 o'clock, it's pier. There's one coming in to the pier, you know? Yeah. And it was quite excitement, really. Then you could sort of stand on the Grand Pier and just watch it sort of circle, then go leave it in as it went over the horizon over to Barry Island. Mm. And it was exciting, this, you know, to see the paddle steamers come in.
We would explore all that Weston had to offer, including Birnbeck Pier, and everybody used it. And when you look back to the books, the Edwardian ladies have those beautiful hats and lovely dresses. I think it should be a themed pier through the ages, and I'm sure that everybody would love to have it open again.
During my time at Weston, we got to know a brother that was a, quote, now an eccentric lady who used to frequent the pier, and she used to carry, if I remember it right, a load of shopping bags. And she would be out there all times of the day and night. We used just to check her and see if she was fine, if she was all right. Then the next day you might see her in town walking about Weston. But she had this way of going to the pier.
In 1933, the reopening of the Grand Pier caused the amusements trade on Birnbeck to tail off and many closed down. In 1990, the pier suffered extensive storm damage.
It's very sad to see, very sad, and it's quite different from my recollection of it. It's a very sad state since I remember it in the mid-60s, and it wasn't all that good then.
Current situation regarding the pier isn't good. The structure is unsafe, and no one can really go on there.
Birnbeck Pier itself is a Grade 2 star listed building. That means it's in the top couple of percent of all heritage buildings in the country, and that makes it very rare and, you know, more special than just local. You and I might think of it as local residents. Actually, it's got national recognition as well. It's potentially a really exciting local attraction.
I know it's beautiful, first and foremost, and I know it's worth saving. So the two most important things for me, I know that it's an absolutely stunningly beautiful Grade 2 star listed pier.
The town of Weston-super-Mare is home to around 70,000 people, as well as the floods of tourists and holidaymakers who come from all over the country in peak holiday times to visit the seaside.
Being on the island once, it was pretty good. We got told to get off, but it was good whilst we were on there.
All I know is that not a lot is happening really with it, and it shouldn't be up and running.
All I know is it's derelict now, and I'm not sure what they're planning to do it in the future. They're constantly saying they're going to make it into apartments or like rebuild it, so yeah, I'm not too certain on what's going on.
I think it should be like turned into an old-fashioned pier with like slot machines.
I want it left how it is. I think it's quite pretty to look at. I've got some cool photos and stuff of it. It's fun to explore on. So.
I'd like it to be renovated, but I think it needs to be renovated keeping its old style.
74% of the people we asked said they did want to see the pier converted into something else and not to be left as an eyesore for the town.
It's privately owned. So at the end of the day, the person who controls it, owns it, needs to do something with it, is the guy who runs the company called CNM Estates, a chap called Waheed Samadi, and he is the owner of Birnbeck Pier. So he's the person who needs to decide what he wants to do and try and get cracking.
Waheed Samadi is now the owner of Birnbeck Pier after purchasing it from Urban Splash back in 2012, and still has yet to revitalise it into the landmark in which it once was.
He's got to take the lead on that, and then the council must try and help, and that's not proving easy at the moment.
I think it's stunning, and it looks like it's about to fall into the sea at any given moment. And I've been there frequently over the last, you know, sort of couple of months, and I'm observing it in its current state. And there literally are sections, there are pieces that you think any minute now, like literally as I'm looking at it, that could just drop into the sea. So much needs to be done. I think every little bit does help. You never really know what you can do. So yes, absolutely, I'll, you know, sign my name to that. But you think, well, what can I actually do? But of course, there's an awful lot you can do. Just making people aware of it is like a good place to start. There are lots of people that don't realise there's a second pier in Weston. So even if it's just sort of getting it out there, you know, and inviting people or encouraging people to walk along, take a look.
The pier in the future to me would be a wonderful feat of engineering if that could be rebuilt to its former glory.
When you think of Weston, a lot of people think of one pier. There are two piers in Weston, and the other one is the most beautiful. The one that people don't know about is the one with most of the history, and that's the one that needs saving.